received a Bachelor of Engineering degree in Mechanical Engineering in 2001 from AISSM's College of Engineering, Pune. He obtained his M.Tech in the area of Thermal and Fluid Engineering in 2008 from Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Technological University, Raigarh, Maharashtra. Being the highest CGPA holder in the M.Tech, he was awarded with the gold medal. He has qualified GATE exam for 5 times with more than 90 percentile. The highest percentile he obtained is 96.79%. Presently, he is pursuing his doctoral program in the field of fluid mechanics from Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Technological University, Raigarh, Maharashtra. He has 19 plus years of teaching experience. He has been invited for expert lecture on heat transfer and GATE preparation in the Pune University and in the Shivaji University, Kolhapur. Presently, he is working as a college NAC coordinator, departmental IQAC coordinator, and departmental exam coordinator. There are around 20 plus research papers published in national and international journals in his credit. So with this short introduction, I would like to invite Mr. Vinod Todkari, sir, to kindly start his session.
Am I audible? Good morning, everyone. This is Vinod Todkari. I'm working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department. And today we'll be discussing about general aptitude. We'll be discussing what is aptitude, what is general aptitude, what is technical aptitude. And in general aptitude, we'll be discussing quantitative and verbal non-verbal aptitude. Before starting the session, as this is my first interaction with you, let me take 1 minute to tell you something about engineering. Rather than engineering, it is about life. The first principle that we should follow is that we should be lifelong learners. You might be knowing Albert Einstein. He always said that I'm a student of physics. He never said that I'm a doctor of physics. He never said that I'm a great scientist. He always said that I'm a student of physics. So we should have that kind of attitude, that kind of approach. Secondly, we have to compete with ourselves. It is said that winning is not coming first, second, or third. Winning is competing with yourself and doing the things in a better way than you had done it before. So we have to compete with ourselves, right? And third thing is that we should be confident enough. It is said that confidence comes not when you know all the answers, but it comes when you are ready to face all questions. So we should be ready to accept all challenges. So with this guidance, or let's say with this some things, we'll start today's presentation. Okay, now see, we'll be discussing this for 1 hour and 15 minutes. For this 1 hour and 15 minutes, we'll follow this principle that work is worship. Whatever we are doing, we'll do it with dedication. We'll do it as a worship, okay? So let us start today's session. These are the contents of today's session. First of all, we'll see what is aptitude. Then we'll see what are the types of aptitude. Then we'll see what is aptitude test. Then we'll see what are the benefits of aptitude test. What are the different parameters in aptitude test? What are the different methods in aptitude test? And then exclusively we'll talk about three things. And on the basis of this, you will be having a test in coming 2-3 days, which is based on aptitude. So in today's session, I will be highlighting about three topics of aptitude, which are common to all. One is number series, second is alphabet analogy, and third is word analogy. Okay, so let us start with what is aptitude. See, aptitude is how fast and how accurate you can think. Speed and accuracy, both are important. Many of the aptitude tests, the time duration is 1 hour, and within 1 hour, you have to attempt 100 questions, right? So within 60 minutes, you have to attempt 100 questions. So within 30 to 35 seconds, you have to answer a question. So speed and accuracy both are important. Why aptitude is important? Because the organization, the company which is absorbing you, they will come to know that how you will perform, learn their culture and how fast you will solve their problems. Then it is a specific capacity or special ability indicative of one's probable success. How successful you will be, that they will come to know from your aptitude score. And as I mentioned earlier, speed and accuracy, both parameters are important. The organization tests your logical reasoning and thinking process. Now, I will just take 1 minute to tell you different types of aptitudes. One is sensory aptitude. This aptitude test is conducted for children so that one comes to know whether their sense organs are developed properly, their hearing ability, sight ability, smell and taste ability, right? Second is mechanical aptitude. Mechanical is how good one is in instrumentation. There are some people, you give them any instrument, even if the instrument is new, they will handle it quite brilliantly. That honing is there, that superficial touch is there. They will dismantle that and then again they will assemble that. So that ability is called as mechanical aptitude. Then there is aptitude called as artistic aptitude. What is artistic aptitude? Your inclination towards artistic things like writing, music, photography, poetry. So that aptitude is called as artistic aptitude. And most important aptitude is professional aptitude. What profession suits you? Generally, when children, they are from 8 to 10 standard, many parents, they conduct their professional aptitude test. There are some organizations which conduct professional aptitude tests. In that professional aptitude test, they determine how, means towards in which field that specific student will be successful, or whether where he is inclined, whether he is inclined towards clerical department or teaching, or he can become a good pilot, or he's inclined towards military. That test is called as professional aptitude test. Then there is scholastic aptitude. This is exclusively deals with your academic. For example, CET exam is there, NEET, JEE exam you have already faced. So that kind of aptitude is called as scholastic aptitude. So if you are having good JEE score, it means that your scholastic aptitude is good. Now, what is an aptitude test? It is a structured method of testing how an individual reacts and performs a particular task, right? So it determines how you will apply acquired knowledge and skills in a specific domain. Now, in the 4 years of engineering, you will be learning the things. And after these 4 years, you will be applying that knowledge. So how good you are, how skilled you are in applying that knowledge, that can be predicted with the help of aptitude test. Aptitude test, logical reasoning and thinking process. Nowadays, multiple choice questions are there. And if you take example of GATE exam or GRE exam, once you click on submit button, immediately you will come to know what is your score. There are some mock GRE test and mock GATE test which are available on internet. I can share the links with you also. So what I mean to say that because of computers, the administration of the MCQs is very easy. Now they are timed strictly, right? Usually 1 minute is given to a question. That is usually within 60 minutes, you have to solve 60 questions. So for every question, you will get only 1 minute. Speed and accuracy are important. And there are broader areas which we are going to discuss in today's session. One is verbal aptitude and one is numerical aptitude. Now, these are some of the benefits of aptitude test. If you conduct professional aptitude test, you will come to know whether you're suitable to that profession. What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? That SWOT analysis, generally we call it as strength, weakness, opportunity and challenges. What are your likes and dislikes? Whether you are inclined towards that field or not. Now, aptitude analyzes your comprehension and communication skill. Comprehension means ability to understand, whether you can understand the things in a proper manner. Then communication skills. Now, for aptitude, communication is very important. Communication doesn't mean only speaking. It consists of 4 dimensions. They are reading, writing, listening, and speaking. 4 facets are important. So communication skills are also tested for. If your aptitude score is good, let's say your score of TOEFL exam is good. It means that you are good in communication. TOEFL is test of English as a foreign language. That we'll discuss afterwards. Okay. Now, aptitude determines your ability to solve problems within strict time constraints. Right? Okay. It determines efficient and objective method for comparing individuals. Right? So if the company is going to absorb you, they will conduct aptitude test and they will check which students are having good aptitude score. right? So they will categorize you. Now it tests your psychological and emotional quotient. Now see, the questions which we are going to discuss in today's session, we are not going to talk about psychological and emotional quotient. There are different types of quotients, like IQ is there, EQ is there, SQ is there, right? What is IQ? IQ is intelligence quotient. What is EQ? EQ is emotional quotient. What is SQ? SQ is social quotient. If you see the selection procedure for any organization, what they do, generally they conduct a written test. So through that written test, they check your IQ. After the written test, you will be having group discussion. So in group discussion, they check your social quotient. And after that group discussion, they will conduct personal interview. In that personal interview, they will check your EQ, that is emotional quotient, whether you are emotionally tough or whether you are emotionally low. So all these quotients are important. Exclusively, if I speak about Army, Navy, and Air Force, their psychological quotient is very important. They conduct tests like word association test, situation reaction test, and through that test, they test your psychological quotient. Because in military applications, your psychological quotient and emotional quotient is very important. Anyway, in today's session, we are going to focus about general aptitude, which is required for every successful career. Okay. So if your aptitude score is good, there are bright chances that you will get selected through interview process, because before conducting the interview, your aptitude test will be conducted, and the person who is going to interview you, he will be having your scorecard with him. So after seeing the scorecard, let's say you are out of 120, you have scored 108 or let's say 119, then he will be impressed. And through that impression, there are bright chances that you will get absorbed. Now there are different kinds of aptitude tests, out of which we are going to discuss only two in today's session, which I have mentioned on this side. First is verbal ability, and second is numerical ability. Verbal ability tests your ability to understand written material. See, for verbal ability, you should have good vocabulary. Many of the times, see, aptitude is conducted to test your logic, but many of the times it happens that our first language is not English. Right? If you talk about India, our first language is not English. In US, the first language is English. Right? So what happens? Many of the students, they are not able to understand the question. Why aptitude test is conducted? It is not conducted to test your English. It is conducted to test your logic. But what happens with us? For many of the students, it happens like they are not able to interpret the question. So because of that, their score goes down. So what I will suggest is that you are lucky that in first lecture itself of induction, we are talking about verbal and vocabulary. Even if you prepare 5 words a day, within a year, 1500 words will be with you. Also, there are some techniques like mnemonics or roots of the word, which I will explain to you. If you understand those techniques, by remembering one root, you can remember 25 words, right? So vocabulary is very important. What I mean to say that, in verbal ability, if the same verbal ability test is conducted in Marathi or in any mother tongue, the students will get good scores. But many of the times, because of lack of interpretation of the question, the scores goes low. So I will recommend that all of you should prepare at least 5 words a day, which will increase your score of verbal ability. Now see, in verbal ability, you have to understand the written material and you have to answer the questions in a logical way, right? You have to apply your logic. It includes everything like spelling, grammar, and ability to understand analogies. Analogy is what we are going to discuss today. Alphabet analogy, number series, and word analogy. And whether you are able to follow the written instructions, that is what is tested. Okay. In numerical ability, you might have given scholarships exams or MTS or NTS exams. You are well acquainted with this numerical ability. When we discuss the questions, the concept will be more clear to you. Now, what the numerical ability test checks? In general aptitude, there are two ability tests. One is verbal ability test and one is numerical ability test. The numerical ability tests your ability to solve numerical problems, like mathematical problems, arithmetic problems, number sequences, and simple mathematics. You may be also given some charts, graphs, and you have to analyze. You have to choose the correct answers which are based on those charts or graphs. Okay, now we'll see where general aptitude is required. General aptitude consists of two parameters. One is verbal non-verbal aptitude and second is quantitative aptitude, which is commonly called as quant. So aptitude consists of quant and verbal. Now there are two types of aptitudes. One is general aptitude, right, which will be required for all domains, all branches. And second aptitude is technical aptitude. Technical means which will be specific to your domain. If I'm a mechanical engineer, if I want to appear for GATE, then I have to prepare basics from mechanical. So technical aptitude is the aptitude which is from the respective domain. If you're from ENTC or if you're from AIDS or if you're from computers, IT, civil, that aptitude test which will be based on your domain, that is called as technical aptitude test. And general aptitude test is common to all. In GATE exam also, there is general aptitude which is common to all branches, like first year of engineering, it is common to all of you. So similarly in GATE exam, the general aptitude is common to all. Now we'll see where this general aptitude is required. General aptitude is required for jobs in public sector undertakings and MNCs. You know that MNCs like Google, they're offering very high packages. The packages are like 1 crore also, right? So there general aptitude is required. You might be knowing that CEO of Google, he is not a computer engineer. He's an electrical engineer, but he is working in computers. He's CEO of Google, right? Why? It is not because of only technical aptitude. It is basically because of general aptitude. So if you are good in general aptitude, you can do anything. And even if you look at the scenario, today's scenario, engineers, they are successful in almost all domains. They are good actors, they are good musicians. You take example of Shankar Mahadevan or plenty of examples. I can exclusively for 1 hour, we can talk about success of engineers in all domains and what are the reasons, right? Okay, anyway, what I mean to say that general aptitude is required if you want to grab an opportunity, a job in MNC, that is multinational companies or public sector undertakings. Then for GATE exam, GATE is graduate aptitude test in engineering exam. Already I have conducted a session which is from GATE and GRE exam. That lecture I have recorded. So after this lecture, maybe I share that link with you so that you will come to know what is GATE exam, what is graduate record examination, that is GRE exam, right? And what are the benefits, what is the syllabus, what is the pattern and everything. I think 100 of you were present for that session of GATE and GRE. Anyway, for those who are not present, I will share the link. Then there is engineering services examination, that is IES, now it is called as ESE, that is engineering section service examination. Then there is MPSC and UPSC. If you look at the scenario, the percentage of engineers getting selected in MPSC and UPSC is very high. What is the reason? The CSAT paper, their CSAT score, that is CSAT is exclusively aptitude. Aptitude score of engineers is too good as compared to other. I'm not comparing it, I'm not making this bold statement, but if you go through syllabus and if you go to the scenario, you'll come to know that the percentage of engineers getting selected in MPSC and UPSC is more than 50%, so which is very high. Even if you want to appear for examinations like junior engineer, SSC examination is there, MSCB, Mahagenco, Mahatransco are there, RRB, Railway Recruitment Board is there, banking exams are there. For all exams, general aptitude is required. And almost in all recruitment processes, even normal organizations, they also conduct aptitude examination. Similarly, there is about technical aptitude. It is required everywhere, right? Okay, so today we'll focus on general aptitude. So initially we'll see some methods and then we'll see three things in detail. What are the four methods to solve aptitude questions from numerical ability? One is traditional method. Second is shortcut method, third is substitution method, and fourth one is elimination method. Now let us see this one by one. Let us take example of a traditional method. The question is, find a number such that when 15 is subtracted from 7 times the number, the result is 10 more than twice the number. Now let us assume that the number is X. So what is given? Find a number such that when 15 is subtracted from 7 times the number, that is 7x minus 15 is equal to 10 more than twice the number, that is 2x plus 10. So if I write simply this equation, 7x minus 15 is equal to 2x plus 10, I will get 5x is equal to 25, that is x is equal to 5. So this is traditional method. Simply you have to assume that the number is x and you have to solve the question. But remember that you have to solve the question in less than 60 seconds. You have to solve the question in 45 seconds, right? Let us take second example. When length of a rectangle is increased by 15% and width is increased by 20%, what is the percentage change in area of the rectangle? Now let us assume that length of the rectangle is L and width of the rectangle is B. Now length is increased by 15%, means new length will be 1.15L. Width is increased by 20%, means new width will be 1.2B. So what will be new area? New area will be 1.15L into 1.2B. So it comes out to be 1.38LB. The old area was LB and new area is 1.38LB. So what do it mean? So the percentage increase in area is 0.38 and we multiply it by 100 because we want to work out percentage. So it will be 38%. So these are straightforward questions which can be solved using our traditional method. Then there are some formulas that we have to memorize. For example, if the question is like this, what is summation of 1 to 10? It is 55. So how you give the answer? You give the answer by the formula n into n plus 1 upon 2. Summation of first n numbers is n into n plus 1 upon 2. Let me take 1 minute. Let me share one story with you. This is one of the biggest inventions in the world. There was a student who was just 14 years old. After the lecture, you can Google for this story. Very interesting story is there. The student was there. Rather than student, a child was there who was going to school. He was just in 7th grade. That is in 7th standard. He was in Germany, right? He was very mischievous. So his teacher used to give him punishment that Gauss carry out a summation of first 100 numbers. So he used to do like 1 plus 2 is 3, then 3 plus 3 is 6, plus 4 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 6 is 26. And he used to do that. He did it for 2 to 3 days. After that, he realized that my teacher is going to give me same punishment. So why not work out a shortcut method? So simply he applied his basics. He carried out summation of 1 to 10 and he observed that the summation of first number and last number is same. The summation of second number and second last number is same. For example, the screen is in front of you. Here, if I want to carry out summation of 1 to 100, the summation of first number is 1 and last number is 100. It is same, 101. Summation of second number and second last number is same. Similarly, second summation of third number and third last number is same. 3 plus 98 is also 101. So you will get 101 plus 101. How many times you will get? You will get it for 50 times. So 101 is nothing but n plus 1. And 50 times is nothing but n by 2. So he worked out a formula n into n plus 1 upon 2. So see, for aptitude, you have to just memorize this formula. If the question is like carry out summation of 1 to 30, so simply it will be 30 into 31 upon 2, n into n plus 1 upon 2. Similarly, there are formulas for squares, right? What is the formula for summation of squares? It is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6. So if I want to carry out summation of 1 to 20, the value of n is 20. So it is 20 into 21 into 41 upon 6. Simply I have substituted the value of n and I will get the sum as 2870. Within 30 seconds, I have got the answer. But if you go conventionally by 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25, like up to 20 square is 400. It will take 5 to 10 minutes for you. And see, the objective is not only to give the correct answer. As I mentioned earlier, if I will make this statement as a bold statement or just highlight this, you just remember this. Aptitude means giving right answers in right time. That right time is very important. Okay. If you want to carry out summation of cubes, what is the formula? The formula is n square into n plus 1 bracket square upon 4. If someone looks at this formula, it is very interesting. The summation of 1 to n and the summation of cubes, only it is squared. Anyway, afterwards, I will talk about this in detail. At this moment, you just remember the formula. It is n square into n plus 1 square upon 4. So if I want to carry out summation of cubes of 1 cube up to 10 cube, it will be 10 square into 10 plus 1 square. 11 square is 121 divided by 4. So that will come out to be 3025. Now there are substitution methods. Now see, this question is in front of you. X square plus 79 square is equal to 172 square minus 88 square minus 8203. If you solve this question by conventional method, at least it will take 3 minutes. Afterwards, you can try this. At least it will take 3 minutes, right? And again, you have to go for square root at the end, which will take 1 minute. So it will take 3 to 4 minutes. But if you apply a simple trick, what is that simple trick? Just focus on the unit value. Just focus on the unit value. What will be unit values? If you talk about left hand side, it will be x square, right? Now, what is the square of 79? That I don't know. But if I look at the unit value is 9. What is square of 9? It is 81. So what will be the number at unit place? It is 1. If you look on the right hand side, if you look at RHS, first is 172 square. So the number at unit place is 2. Square of 2 is 4. Again, square of 8 is 64. So again, the number at unit place will be 4. And last number is straight forward. It is 8203. So what is the number at unit place? It is 3. So it will be like 4 minus 4 minus 3. So if I calculate the number at unit place, now see on the right hand side, it is 4 minus 4 minus 3. If you do conventionally, 4 minus 4 is 0 and 0 minus 3, right? 0 minus 3, you may write minus 3, but it is not like that. We are looking at the unit value. 0 is at the unit place. So some number will be there at the 10 place. 0 is at the unit place. The number may be like 10, the number may be like 20, the number may be 100, right? So 0 is there at unit place. So when 0 is there at unit place and when you subtract 3 at unit place, what you do, you take carry as 1. Right? So the number will be 7. So what will be x square? X square for unit value at x square will be 6. So x will be square root of a number, right, whose unit place is 6. Now, which are the numbers which are having square values? At the square values, they are having unit as 6. Either it can be 4 because 4 square is 16, or it can be 6 because 6 square is 36. For 4 square, the value at unit place is 6, or for 6 square, the value at unit place is 6. Now, if you look at the options A, B, C, D, only A is there, which is having 6 at unit place. So option A is correct. So within 1 minute, we have worked out the numerical. Now there is elimination method. Let us take this simple example. The ages of A and B are in the ratio of 7:4. After 5 years, the ages are in the ratio 11:7. Then what is the value of A? Now see, A is to B is 7:4. So A must be a multiple of 7. B must be a multiple of 4. But I am not bothered about B because I have to find A. So my focus is on A. So first thing is that A must be a multiple of 7. Out of the given options, which is a multiple of 7? There are two options like D and D. 14 and 28 are multiples of 7. So either B or D may be correct. Now second condition is what? After 5 years, A and B must be in a ratio of 11:7. So after 5 years, A must be a multiple of 11. Now, if I take A as 14, after 5 years, what will be age of A? 14 plus 5 is 19. 19, is it a multiple of 11? No, it is not a multiple of 11. So that option is wrong. So if I try with 28, after 5 years, what will be age of A? 28 plus 5 is 33. And that is a multiple of 11. Right? So which option is correct? Option D is correct. So if you look at the question, two things are there that should strike to your mind. Firstly, A should be a multiple of 7 and A plus 5 must be a multiple of 11. Right? If I convert this question into a numerical question, what will be the question? A must be a multiple of 7 and A plus 5 must be a multiple of 11. 28 satisfies both conditions. That's why the correct option is 28. Okay. Now in verbal aptitude, you must be good in English. Now in today's session, we'll discuss 60 to 70 questions which are from verbal and quant aptitude. Now let us start one by one. A person who knows many languages is called as, you can type the answer in your chat box, right? Okay. One is linguist, one is grammarian, third is C is monolingual and D is bilingual. Now see, mono means one, right? By means two. Even if you don't know the correct answer, I will tell you how to work out, how to predict the correct answer. Monolingual languages. Grammarian, he's concerned with the grammar of a language, right? So only option left is linguist. So the correct option is linguist. Okay. One who possesses many talents. You might be knowing that versatile actor is there, right? Versatile means he's an actor, he's a singer, he's a musician, he's a composer, right? So versatility, he's good in all facets, multifaceted. So the option correct is versatile, right? Okay. The third question is the one who eats everything. You might be knowing, you might not be knowing omnivorous, but you might be knowing herbivorous, carnivorous. What is herbivorous? In Marathi, we call it as shakahari. What is omnivorous or what is carnivorous? Carnivorous means mausahari, the one who eats flesh, right? Now, here you can apply logic. Vorous is concerned with eating and omni means all, right? So you can tick the option as omnivorous. You have to go to the root of the word. Omniscient, omni means all, scient means science, the one who knows all science, right? So what is the correct option? The correct option is option A, which is omnivorous. Okay, I saw a dash dash of cows in the field. Now, what are the options? The options are like group, we generally call group of people or crowd, herd, shoal and flock. The group of fish is called as shoal. Right? The group of birds is called as flock. We say that birds having same feather flock together, right? So group of birds is called as flock, group of fish is called as shoal, group of cows is called as herd. So the correct option is not A, but it is B, because group of cows is called as herd. So for verbal, your English should be quite good. Now see, Rama was so badly injured that he needed care in the hospital. Which kind of care is needed in the hospital if you are injured badly? Accident patients, if they are injured badly, they are taken to ICU. The ICU is abbreviation for what? What is the long form of ICU? It is intensive care unit. So you need intensive care. So the correct option is option D. Synonym for candid. What is the meaning of synonym? Having similar meaning. What is the meaning of antonym? Antonym means having opposite meaning. Candid, right? What is the question? What is the synonym of candid? What is the similar word of candid? Candid means honest. In photographs, we said it is a candid photograph. On WhatsApp, many times you write that, very candid photograph. Candid means frank, honest, right? So the option C is correct. Now, the next question is this. A person who is not sure about existence of God is. Now see, if I reframe the question, if I ask the question that a person who believes in God, which option will be correct? Option D will be correct. A person who believes in God is called as theist. In Marathi, we call it as astik, right? If I reframe the question and if I put the question like a person who doesn't believe in God at all, who is sure that God does not exist, the option will be C, atheist. Atheist in Marathi, we call it as nastik, right? Okay. The person who is not sure about the existence of God, which is the question, that person is called as agnostic, right? What is cynic person? Cynic person is the person who looks for negative in everything. That person is called as cynic person. Anyway, so what is the correct option for this? The question is a person who is not sure about existence of God, that person is called as agnostic. Okay. Now, what is antonym of mortal? Mortal in Marathi we call it as mrtya. Right? What is opposite word of mortal? Obviously, it will be immortal. Right? Also, we can discuss the other options, but due to lack of time, I will go somewhat fast. Right? The antonym of mortal is immortal. Okay. Now, these type of questions are also there in verbal aptitude. What kind of questions are there? Parts of a statement are given, and we have to frame the correct sequence. Now see, if you look at P, Q, R and S, if I want to frame a statement, the statement will be like posh air conditioned, fully furnished rooms are available for gentlemen of test. So what sequence I have followed? I have followed the sequence like P, S, R, Q. So which option is correct? Option B, which is P, S, R, Q. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, now some grammatical questions are there. The man dash dash my house was a cheat. Blank space is there. We have to fill up the blank space with correct, grammatically correct option. So which option is grammatically correct? Yes, the man blank space my house was a cheat. Will it be to whom I sell, or will it be to who I sell, or who was sold to, or it will be to whom I sold? The correct option will be, even if you read the statement, no, you will find the rhythm. You will know which option is correct. The man to whom I sold, right? So option D is correct. Okay. Now we'll discuss only one question about technical aptitude, because technical aptitude will be different for all branches, and you are from different branches. Like some students are from mechanical, some are from ENTC, some are from computers. I will just tell you what is technical aptitude. What technical aptitude is, the aptitude which is related to your specific domain, right? For example, if this question is there, steel is to rails, so Alnico is to what? Yes, can anyone type the answer in chat box and tell me what is the logic behind it? Now, steel is an alloy which is used to manufacture rails. Alnico is an alloy which is used to manufacture permanent magnets. So which option is correct? Option D is correct. So questions from this type, this category, they are called as technical aptitude questions. Okay. Now we'll see three parts. First is number series, right? Second is word analogy, and then we will discuss alphabet analogy. So initially we'll start with number series. What is number series? It is a collection of numbers or ordered sequence of numbers where each term follows a predefined rule. Generally we call it as rhythm. So to solve the questions from number series, we have to understand that rhythm, right? And based on this rhythm, we can find the succeeding terms. So most important part is to find the logic behind the number series, and the logic behind the number series is called as rhythm. So the objective in this is to, you have to understand the logic, you have to understand the rhythm. We'll discuss the question so that the concept will be clear to you. Let's take first question. The series is like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next place is bank. So what is the rhythm in this? They are real numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Obviously a child can answer that next number will be 7. Next series: 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Now, what is the rhythm? They are consecutive even numbers. So next number will be obviously 14. Now, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. If you look at the numbers, they are consecutive odd numbers. So what will be third number, next number? The next number will be 13. Now, this is a table of four. If you look at the figures, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16, 4 fives are 20, 4 sixes are 24. So next will be 4 sevens are, that is 28. Now next, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36. What rhythm do you hear in this? 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36. All are squares. 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, 5 square, 6 square. So next should be 7 square, that is 49. Next, 1, 8, 27, 64, 125, 216. What rhythm you can work out over here? It is cubes. The numbers are cubes of successive numbers, like 1 cube, 2 cube, 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27, 4 cube is 64, 5 cube is 125, 6 cube is 216. So next will be 7 cube, which is 343. Now, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. These are the numbers. So what will be the next number? The next number, these are prime numbers. So next number will be 17. The prime numbers which succeeds after 13 is 17. Now, the next example is 9, 16, 23, 30, 37. What rhythm do you find over here? If you take difference between first and second number, the difference is of plus 7, right? The difference between 9 and 16 is 7. The difference between 16 and 23 is 7. The difference between 23 and 30 is again 7. The difference between 30 and 37 is again 7. So the rhythm is plus 7. So if you add 7 in 37, you will get your answer as 44. Okay. Next question is this: 67, 58, 49, 40, 31. What rhythm that we can observe over here? The rhythm is minus 9, right? So if you take the difference between 67 and 58, the difference is of 9, right? And it is minus 9, it is subtracted. So the rhythm is minus 9. The difference between 58 and 49 is again minus 9. The difference between 49 and 40 is again minus 9. So again, if you subtract 9 from 31, what answer you will get? You'll get the answer as 22. Now next, look at the next question. The next question is 14, 70, 350. Then there is a blank space, 8750 and 43750. Now if you look at 14 and 17, and if you take the ratio is 5. 14 5s are 70. 70 5s are 350. So the rhythm is multiplication by 5. The next number will be obtained if you multiply the previous number, preceding number by 5. So if you multiply 350 by 5, you will get your answer as 1750. And also you can check your answer. Again, if you multiply 1750 by 5, you will get your answer as 8750. Okay. Now, next series, it is 8000, 1600, 320, 64. What is the rhythm in this? 8000 and 1600. 1600 is 1/5 of 8000. So you have multiplied by 1 upon 5. Multiplying by 1 upon 5 means multiplying by 0.2. Or also you can say that I have multiplied by 1 upon 5. So let us check for second and third number. Second number is 1600 and third number is 320. So if you multiply 1600 by 1 upon 5, you will get 320. If you multiply 320 by 1 upon 5, you will get 64. On the same line, if you multiply 64 by 1 upon 5, you will get the answer as 12.8. So the correct answer is 12.8. Now next, the series is like 200, 231, 264, 299. And we have to predict the next number. Now, if you look at the difference between first number and second number, it is 31. If you look at the difference between second and third number, it is 33. Next difference is 35. So obviously the next difference should be 37. And when you add 37 in 299, you'll get the answer as 336. I believe that you are getting this. Just you have to see which rhythm you can follow, whether it will be addition rhythm, whether it will be subtraction rhythm, whether it will be multiplication rhythm, or whether it will be division rhythm, right? In this, difference rhythm is there. That is subtraction, or you can say difference rhythm is there. Okay. Now, next question is this. Now, if you look at the difference between first two numbers is 23. That is the difference between 705 and 728 is 23. The difference between second and third number is 46, right? So immediately this should click to your mind that the difference is like a table of 23. First difference is 23, second is 46. So it is a table of 23. So 23 ones are 23, 23 twos are 46, 23 threes are 69. So you have to add 69 in 774 so that you will get answer as 843. Okay. Now let us discuss this question. This is asked in GATE exam, that in a cricket match, you know that in a cricket match, 11 players are there, right? Out of the 11 players, if 10 players got bowled out, right? They are not run out or they are not catch out. If all 10 players got bowled out on successive balls, right? That is, on first ball, player number one will get bowled. On second ball, player number three will get bowled. So which number player will remain not out? So what will be answer for this? The answer will be option. Yes, can you write the answer in chat box? So the correct answer is option C. That is player number 8. He will remain not out. Why? See, on first ball, first number player will get bowled out. On second ball, third number player will get bowled out, because second number player is at the runner end, right? On third ball, fourth number player. On fourth ball, fifth number player. On fifth ball, sixth number player. On sixth ball, seventh number player will get bowled out. So at the end of over, that is on sixth ball, seventh number player will get bowled out, and eighth number player will come, right? But when he comes, there will be change of crease, right? So he will go at the runner end. So he will remain not out, right? So eighth number player will remain not out. Okay, anyway. Now, what is antonym of enormous? Enormous means plenty, huge, right? So what is antonym? That is opposite word of enormous. What is opposite of huge in this case? Obviously, soft will not be there, average will not be there, weak will not be there. Yes, correct. It is tiny. It is option C, which is tiny. Okay, now this is word analogy. You have to work out rhythm. You have to work out logic in the words. For this, first thing is that you must know the rhythm. You must know the logic and you must know the words. You should be good in vocabulary as well as logic. Now, flow is to river. So stagnant is to what? What logic you can apply? Flowing water forms a river, right? So stationary water forms what? Stationary water forms pool. So which option is correct? Option C is correct. Okay. Conference is to chairman. So newspaper is to what? Now who is chairman? The head person of conference is chairman. So what is the logic? Second is the head of first. Chairman is the head of conference. So who is the head of newspaper? It is editor. Very good. It is correct. Head of newspaper is editor. Now we'll see alphabet analogy and then we'll see word analogy. In alphabet analogy, this comes in numerical. I repeat, alphabet analogy comes in numerical. Even if it looks as a verbal, it is not apart from verbal, it is apart from numerical. Now you know that in English language, 26 alphabets are there, right? Now alphabet A is the first alphabet. So what is the number for alphabet A? It is 1. And alphabet Z is the last alphabet. So what is the number for alphabet Z? It is 26. Now see, in competitive exams, you are having very less time. So you are not able to like write down these and copy these values and apply the logic. You have to memorize. Whenever the word A comes, you should click, it should click that it is number 1. B is 2, C is 3, D is 4, E is 5, F is 6, similarly up to Z. Right? For example, S means 19, T means 20. I remember it like this, Ejoty. E-J-O-T-Y. The E is 5, J is 10, O is 15, T is 20, and Y is 25. So I leave it to you. When I was in doing my graduation in the year 2000, I remembered this, E-Jyoti, right? So the numbers are like E corresponds to 5, J corresponds to 10, O corresponds to 15, T corresponds to 20, and Y corresponds to 25. Technique, you can choose. You can choose any technique. Only thing is that you must be able to recall. You must be able to recollect. So we'll see the questions. In alphabet analogy, you have to remember first thing is this. Like each alphabet carries a value. Alphabet A means value 1. Alphabet O means value 15. Alphabet Z means value 26. Now, the question is in front of you. If AC belongs to CF, MO belongs to what? Now, don't consider alphabets, consider the values. A means 1, C means 3, right? Again, C means 3 and F means 6. So what I can write? I can write 1-3 corresponds to 3-6. So if you look at first alphabet is A, right? And in next, the first alphabet is C. So here it is 1, here it is 3. What is the relation between 1 and 3? So the logic is plus 2. So for alphabet, we have to do plus 2. Now, second alphabet is C and here it is F. So it is number 3 and number 6. So what is the logic? The logic is plus 3. So what is the logic here? For first alphabet, it is plus 2 and for second alphabet, it is plus 3. Now, MO, M means 13, O means 15. So what logic I have to apply? For first alphabet, it should be plus 2 and for second alphabet, it should be plus 3. So what will be next? Logic is plus 2 plus 3. So it will be 59, 18. So which corresponds to 15 O and which corresponds to 18 R? So which option is correct? Option C, that is OR. Tell me very honestly, is the type of questions clear to you? This is called as alphabet analogy. For alphabet, we have to write numbers and we have to work out the logic. Now, let us discuss next question. The next question is DFH corresponds to FHD. So MOQ corresponds to what? Now D, immediately, what is the number for D? It is 4. F means 6. So similarly, you have to write. So 4, 6, 8 corresponds to 6, 8, 4. Now here, if you see 4 and 6, what is the logic? Plus 2. Second is 6 and 8, so plus 2. Third is 8 and 4, so it is minus 4. So what is the logic? The logic is plus 2, minus 4. Right? So here, MOQ, I have written the numbers 13, 15, 17. And what is the logic? Plus 2, minus 4. So 13 plus 2 is 15, 15 plus 2 is 17, and 17 minus 4 is 13. Right? Logic is plus 2, minus 4. So 15, 17, 13. So the option will be 15 corresponds to O, 17 corresponds to Q, and 13 corresponds to M. So the correct option is OQM. Okay. Now, if you are having notebook and pen, you can work it out and you can tell me the answer. Right? Just give me answer within 30 to 35 seconds. Which option is correct? I will wait for 10 seconds. C corresponds to 3, D corresponds to 4, E corresponds to 5, F corresponds to 6, right? So what we'll write over here? 3, 4, 5, 6 corresponds to what? 13, 14, 15, 16. So what is the logic? First is 3, here first is 13, so it is plus 10. Then 4, 14, so plus 10. 5, 15, so plus 10. 6, 16, so plus 10. Right? So the logic is plus 10, plus 10, plus 10, plus 10. Now, J, K, L, M corresponds to what? The number for J is 10. For K, it is 11. For L, it is 12. For M, it is 13. So simply you have to add 10 in everything. So 10 plus 10 is 20. 11 plus 10 is 21. 12 plus 10 is 22. And 13 plus 10 is 23. So the answer is 20, 21, 22, 23. So the alphabets corresponding to 20, 21, 22, 23 are T, U, V, W. So also you can apply the logic that these numbers are in series, these are also in sequence, right? C, D, E, F, M, N, O, P. So J, K, L, M is equal to what? Just you have to work out the first number and you have to see the sequence. The sequence, they should be sequential, right? Now T, U, V, W, that is in sequence. So option B is correct. Sometimes you can apply short tricks also, right? Okay, I believe that it is clear to you. Now, next question is this. PNS corresponds to OOT. So DBH corresponds to what? I will give you 30 seconds. You can work out and you just write which option is correct in the chat box. Take 30 seconds, think on it, write down the numbers corresponding to PNS, corresponding to OOT, right? Okay. So the answer is this. PNS corresponds to OOT. So P corresponds to O, right? So the logic is minus 1. N corresponds to O, so the logic is plus 1. And S corresponds to T, so the logic is plus 1. Similarly for DBH, if you apply the same logic, minus 1 plus 1 plus 1. D minus 1 is C, B plus 1 is C, and H plus 1 is I. Right, so which option is correct? CCI. And where is CCI? It is in option C. So option C is correct. Now next question is this. AHOP corresponds to CKSU. So BJMF corresponds to what? Now apply your logic, write down the numbers. You need not write down the numbers also. You can apply your logic. Maybe it will be like A and C. Only one number is missing. The middle number is missing. A, then B is missing and it is C. So B, then C will be missing and next will be D. So either it will be A or D, right? Either it will be DQKLM or DMQK. And then you can try with other last number. Let's say here it is P, here it is U. It depends on you, whether you write down the numbers or you write down your own tricks. Tell me, what will be the correct answer? You can write the answers in chat box. Now see, the option is this. What is the logic behind this? The logic is plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. So if you apply the same logic, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, you will get the option as DMQK. Now, next is this. ZA corresponds to YB. So XC corresponds to what? What will be the correct answer? See, Z and Y, it is very simple. Z and Y means minus 1. A and B means plus 1. X minus 1 will be what? And C plus 1 will be what? X minus 1 will be W and C plus 1 will be D. So the correct option is WD. The logic is minus 1 plus 1. Now, just work out this one and tell me what is the correct answer. The question is DBU corresponds to EEZ. I repeat, DBU corresponds to EEZ. So CJH corresponds to what? So if you apply the logic, for first number, the logic is plus 1. For second alphabet, the logic is plus 3. And for last alphabet, the logic is plus 5. So if you apply the same logic for the second sequence, that is CJH, if you do plus 1, plus 3, and plus 5, you will get the answer as DMM, right? So that DMM option is correct. So similar logic will be followed over here. Now think on this question. I want answer from your side. Yes, can anyone give the answer? I will be very happy if I get answer from your side because this question is totally different. It will test your logic. Now see, if you look at the left hand side, only three alphabets are there. And if you look at the right hand side, there are six alphabets. So FIG corresponds to EGHJFH, right? So the first alphabet F corresponds to first two, because 3 corresponds to 6. It means every alphabet corresponds to 2. So F corresponds to E and G. I corresponds to H and J, and G corresponds to F and H. So what logic you can find over here? F corresponds to E and G. E is before F and G is after F. I corresponds to H and J. H is before I and J is after I. Now look at the last alphabet. G corresponds to FH. F is before G and H is after G. So B, I, N. Now tell me, B will corresponds to what? What is before B and after B? Before B, A is there, and after B, C is there. So first will be AC, right? I corresponds to what? I corresponds to HJ, right? So it will be AC, HJ. So option D will be correct. N corresponds to what is before N and what is after N? Before N, M is there, and after N, O is there. So option D is correct, which is AC, HGMO. I believe that the concept is clear to you. Now, similar kind of question is there, but some logic you can apply over here, because it consists of 7 words. So if you write down the logic for 7 alphabets, it will be difficult for you. Some questions are there which consist of 10 alphabets. So working out logic for every alphabet, that is 10 logics, that is plus 1, minus 4, minus 6, whatever it may be, it will take at least 2 minutes, and you have to solve the question in 2 minutes. So you can apply a trick that, see whether you find any rhythm in this. The first letter over here is B, right? And the first letter over here is Y, right? The last letter over here is D, and last letter over here is W. So can you find any logic in this? I will give you a hint. B is second alphabet, Y is second last alphabet. D is fourth alphabet, W is fourth last alphabet, right? So also you have to remember this, opposite letters of alphabet. How will you write opposite letters of alphabet? Simply 26 alphabets are there. So you can write it like this, 13 and 13. Like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. M is the 13th one. Then below 13th, write down the 14th, and then proceed in this direction, from right to left. So it will be N, O, P, Q, R, right? So what is opposite of A? Opposite of A is Z. What is opposite of B? B is second alphabet, Y is second last alphabet. C is third alphabet, X is third last alphabet. D is fourth alphabet, W is fourth last alphabet. So these are called as opposite letters of alphabets. Now in this case, if you see B and Y, they are opposite alphabets. L and O, they are opposite alphabets. So this number is there. So for O, which is the opposite alphabet, it is L. So for O, L will be there. So either the option will be A or C. What is the last alphabet? The last alphabet is S, right? What is the opposite alphabet for S? It is H, right? So which option is correct? Option A is correct. Tell me, is it clear to you? As I mentioned earlier, aptitude is not working out correct answer. If someone gives you the question paper and he asks you that, take your own time and work out this. If the paper is for 1 hour and if you take 10 hours, I'm sure even if it is an 8th standard student, he will get 100 out of 100. So aptitude is not about working out only correct answers. That is just 50% part of it. It is about working out correct answers in minimal time. You have to take minimum time. You must know the short tricks. You must be logically tough. In short, you must have a good learnability. You should learn the things very fast. See, aptitude determines your learnability. How good learner you are, how fast you can learn the things. So that is nothing but aptitude. Okay, next question is this. So even if you write down, the logic is very simple. It is plus 2 minus 2 plus 2 minus 2. And if you apply the logic, you will get the answer. Okay, now we'll see some questions which are based on word analogy. In word analogy, as I told you earlier, the words must be known to you. You must be acquainted with the vocabulary. At the same time, you must be good at logic. Now, for example, the question is like this. Ornithologist corresponds to birds. So anthropologist corresponds to what? So what is the logic in this? The first one studies the second one. Ornithologist studies birds. So anthropologist studies what? Anthropology is a branch of science which deals with the study of mankind, evolution of mankind, right? So which option will be correct? It will be option C, right? Okay. Now just type your answer in answer box and tell me what is the logic behind this. Purge is to fresh water, right? Purge is to fresh water. So what will correspond to salt water? Now you must be good in vocabulary and you must be good in logic. Now what is purge? Purge is a fish which is obtained in fresh water, right? So which fish is obtained in salt water? It is a fish, so it cannot be crocodile, it cannot be frog, it cannot be snake. So you might be knowing cod liver oil. Cod is the fish which is obtained in salt water. So which option is correct? It is option C. Very good, Rupesh. Okay, fine. Next question is this. Insert is to extract. So mighty is to what? Tell me what is logic in this? Insert and extract. You insert data, you extract data. Insert means give. Extract means take out. So they are antonyms, right? Mighty, mighty means powerful, right? So what will be antonym of powerful? Opposite of powerful, it will be weak, right? And which is the word which is corresponding to weak in this section? Yes, which will be correct option? Logic is antonyms. Insert, the antonym is extract. So mighty, what will be the antonym? It is feeble. Feeble means weak. Okay, hill is to mountain. So what is to pen? Now what is the logic in this? Hill and mountain, larger hills are called as mountains. So larger something is called as pen. Initially you will have something and then you will have pen. So which option will be correct? It will be distress. Distress leads to pen. Okay. So the logic is second is a bigger form of first. Now, bird chirp. So horse is to what? What is the logic in this? Bird makes chirping voice, right? So horse, the sound produced by horse is called as what? It is called as neigh. Tell me, is it clear to you? Now, cardiologist is to heart. So zoology is to what? Tell me, what is the logic in this? Cardiology is the study of heart. If anyone is having heart issues, right? So he will go to cardiologist. So zoology is the study of what? Cardiology is the study of heart. So zoology is the study of what? Yes, what will be the correct option? Zoology is the study of animals. If I ask you botany, then it will be plants, right? So in this case, zoology, so it will be animals, right? Okay. Burglar is to house. So pirate is to what? Tell me what logic you will apply and what will be the correct option. What is the logic? Very good, very good. Rupesh, what is the logic in this? First one robs the second. That option is correct. Burglar robs house. So pirates robs ship. So that option is correct. Very good. Now cord is to telephone, right? So what is to television? Which option is correct? Yes, I am unable to see that. Shubham. See, option B will be correct. What is the logic? Cord is a part of telephone. You might not have seen because you are using mobiles, right? Previously, there were telephones, right? Cord was an integral part of telephone. So similarly, screen is an integral part of television. Okay, now tell me this, what is to wrist as belt is to vest? Logic is we wear belt on vest. So what thing we wear on wrist? What thing we wear on wrist? Do we wear arm on wrist or hand on wrist or band on wrist or bracelet on wrist? Which option will be correct? Obviously it will be bracelet. Option D is correct. So you have to find the logic. You have to find the logic. Okay. Scientist is to experiment. So what is there with play? Tell me what is the logic and what is the correct answer? The logic is scientists perform experiments. So who performs plays? It is actor. So which option is correct? It is option C. Okay, Now tell me this. Sloth is to action. So what is to principles? Initially tell me, what is sloth? Sloth is lack of action. Lack of action leads to sloth. So lack of principles leads to what? It is unscrupulousness. Scrupulous means, see, you should do the work scrupulously, means you should do the work ethically. You should do the work meticulously, means you should go for every minute details. Scrupulous means ethical. I repeat, scrupulous means ethical, right? So unscrupulous means unethical. So lack of principles means lack of ethics. That is unscrupulousness. Tell me, is it clear to you? So lack of second leads to first. This is the logic in this, right? Okay, now tell me this. I expect answer from your side for this. And also tell me the logic. Epilogue is to novel. So what is to mean? Where do we find epilogue? We find epilogue at the end of novel, right? Right? So what we do after meal? We take sweet dish. So it is nothing but dessert. Sweet dish is also called as a dessert. Tell me, is it clear to you? Now, what is to court case? Like abstract is to research paper. You might not be well acquainted with these words, but abstract is the short form. Rather than short form, I will say it is a brief summary, in short summary of research paper. You will not read all research papers, right? You will just read abstract, and from that abstract, you will come to know what contents are there in research paper. Like in movies, we are having trailers, right? You just see the trailer and then you decide whether to see that movie or not. Similarly, in research papers, there are abstracts. So we read abstracts and then we decide whether we should get that research paper or not. So in short, abstract is the short documentation or brief documentation about research paper. So the short documentation about court case, it is called as brief. It is a legal language, but you must be good in vocabulary. Now tell me this. I want you to answer this. What is to peace as lion is to courage? Tell me, what is the logic and which option is correct? Lion is to courage. Lion is the symbol for courage. So which is the symbol for peace? Yes, it is dove. Dove is the symbol of peace. Now tell me this. What is to launch? Now if you see, the spellings appears to be same, but there is a slight difference. What is to launch as breakfast is to lunch? Very good. Prajapta, it is correct. It is countdown. See, breakfast we take before lunch. Before launching of anything, what we do? We do countdown. Let's say launching of a satellite, we do countdown like 10 seconds, 9 seconds, 8 seconds. Or let's say you are going to launch a business, then you, or let's say Maruti is going to launch a vehicle. So they say 60 days to go, 59 days to go, 2 weeks to go. So that is countdown, right? So like breakfast precedes lunch, countdown precedes launch, right? It is launch. Okay. Now, time is to waste, right? Time is to waste, so money is to what? See, it is not spent, Prajapta, that is wrong. If you have utilized time, then you can say, I have spent time in studies, right? Have you said that I have wasted time in studies? So spent in wrong manner. Time spent in wrong manner is called as wastage of time. So money spent in wrong manner is called as what? It is called as money squandered. We say in Marathi, tani paisa vaya ghalola. That is nothing but squander, right? So which option is correct? Option D is correct. So you have to find the logic. If it is like time utilized, then money will be spent, right? But time waste, so money will be squandered. Now tell me this option. Monarchy is to king. Monarchy is to king. So aristocracy is to what? Now see, monarchy is the kingdom which is ruled by the king. So aristocracy is run by whom? If the question is like this, that monarchy is to king, right? No, it is not wealthy. If the question is like this, democracy is to what? What will be option? if the question, if I reframe the question, if I rewrite the question like monarchy is to king, right? So democracy is to what? What is democracy? Government run by the people for the people. So option will be people, right? Aristocracy is the government which is run by nobles, which is run by very good people, right? That is called as aristocracy. See, from single word you have to remember, cracy means ruled, right? Aristocracy is there, monocracy is there, bureaucracy is there, democracy is there. So from a single root, we can remember 100 words, right? Okay. So the correct option is nobles. Now Hong Kong is to China. So Vatican is to what? What is the logic in this? Hong Kong is a city in China. So Vatican is a city in Rome. Yes, Pratik, it is correct. The answer is Rome. Now painting is to artist, right? So symphony is to what? In short, what is the logic? First is done by the second. Painting is done by artist. So symphony is done by whom? Yes. It is composer. So option D is correct. Now simple mathematical question. South is to northwest. So west is to what? What is logic in this? If you simply draw north, south, east and west, what is that angle between south and northwest? The angle is 135 degrees in clockwise direction. Now if you move from west, right, in clockwise direction for 135 degrees, if you move by 90 degrees, you'll get what? You'll get north, right? And after again 45 degrees, you'll get northeast. Very good. Whoever has correct, tick that option. That option is correct. The option is northeast. Very good. So what is the logic? The logic is that difference between first and second is 135 degrees angle, which is measured in clockwise direction. I believe it is clear to you. So now tell me this. What is to flood? What is to flood as helmet is to injury? Tell me what is the logic. The answer is wrong. Option is not C. Option is also not B. Now only what is left, all three options are wrong. Whatever you have told, that is wrong. What is left now? Three options are wrong. So what is left? It is levy, right? See, what is the logic? Helmet prevents injury. See, if the same question was asked in Marathi, like helmet prevents injury, everyone knows helmet and injury, right? So what prevents flood? If you're from civil, you must be knowing levy means bandh, right? Bandh that is used to prevent flood, right? So option is levy. See, what I mean to say that you are good in logic. It is not that you are not good in logic, but you are not acquainted with these words. So what you have to do, you have to develop your vocabulary. Now Coast Guard, that person is there. So how we can prevent flood? Drowned, right? Or river, it makes no sense. Levy means bang. So that prevents flood, right? So we have to work on our vocabulary. And for vocabulary, different techniques are there. I will share those documents with you. I'm having my YouTube channel by the name Vinod Todkari, right? After lecture, I can share the link with you so that you can subscribe to that channel, right? Okay, so levy prevents flood. Now, tell me which option is correct? Ransom is to captive. So what is to service? If I ask the same question in Marathi, ransom means what? Khandani. Captive means apaharan. After apaharan, the people ask for khandani. So if you do service, you will ask for what? You will not ask for a prisoner. You will not ask for restaurant. You will not ask for military. You will ask for gratuity. Right? Gratuity is the amount which is paid after a service, after a span of service. So the correct option is gratuity. See, you have to apply some logic, even if you don't know these words, right? Ransom is a money that you know. So prisoner, is it a money? No. Military, is it a money? No. Restaurant, is it a money? No. Gratuity is a money. Gratuity, provident fund, these are the monies. So option B is correct. So option B, that is gratuity, is correct. So if ransom is to captive, gratuity will be equal to service. Okay, now I expect an answer from your side. I'm taking quite high time, but it's okay. It will develop your aptitude. Now tell me, what is to course as menu is to meal? Now, if you go to have a meal, right? You will ask for a menu card. Yes? It is syllabus. Very good, Akash. The answer is syllabus. So what is the logic? Syllabus is description of course and menu is description of meal. So which option is correct? Option D, that is syllabus is correct. Now tell me this. Colossal is to enormous. So constant is to what? Colossal means plenty, huge. Enormous means also plenty, huge. So both are synonyms. Colossal and enormous, they are synonyms, right? So constant, what is the synonym for constant? Let's say your relation with your friend remains constant, right? Why it remains constant? Because he is faithful, right? Faithful is the synonym for constant. If anything is faithful, it will remain constant throughout. So the correct option is faithful. Now tell me, glasses is to what? Bicycle is to unicycle. Now tell me, what is the logic in bicycle and unicycle? You know that bicycle is having two wheels and unicycle means it is having only one wheel. In circus, we see that unicycle, right? It is having only one wheel. Very good. So glasses, they are having two lenses. So monocle, they are having single lens. Very good. That option is correct. The option is monocle, right? Because it is having only one lens. Very good. Now tell me, this is the last question. Deficient is to complete. So what is to static? Deficient and complete, these are antonyms, right? So static means stationary. What is the antonym of stationary? In motion. So that is nothing but kinetic. What option you have clicked, that is correct. Okay, very good. Okay, so this is the end of my presentation, right? Maybe I have covered the issues at a very fast pace, but my objective was that you should come to know about what are the different sections in aptitude. First of all, just understand that for every sector, there will be aptitude test, irrespective of your branch, irrespective of your specialization. For every career, it may be a career in MNC, it may be a career in PSU, it may be hello, am I audible? Can you hear my voice? Sorry, there was internet interruption. Okay, fine. So what I mean to say is that I will conclude with this, that in every branch, for every successful career, it may be a career in PSU or MNC, or even if you want to become entrepreneur, even if you want to appear for GRE gate, everywhere, MSCB, RTO inspector, maybe in careers in civil, some technical exams in civil, general aptitude is required everywhere, right? So after 2-3 days, we'll conduct a test, which will be based on these three dimensions, what we have discussed in today's session, right? Which three dimensions we have discussed? One is word analogy, alphabet analogy, and number series. So within these 2-3 days, we'll conduct a test on this. As I told you that in aptitude, not only you should give correct answers, but you should give correct answers in correct time. So you have to solve the answers in correct time. Okay. So aptitude is about giving correct answers in correct time. So I would just like to thank you for your patient listening, right? This lecture I will upload on my YouTube channel. I'm having a YouTube channel by my name, which is Vinod Todkari, right? You can subscribe to that channel. So I will just hand over the mic to Tejas, sir. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for patient listening.
Thank you, sir. I hope you all enjoyed the lecture. I the hope is not a correct word. I must say you all have enjoyed the lecture because it reflects in your replies on the Meet. And so, sir, have touched all the aspects of the aptitude being focused on the numerical series, alphabet analogy, and word analogy. So, sir, have explained the different methods for solving aptitude, and you may come to know how important will this lecture to you when you start the preparation for GATE and other competitive examinations. So, on the behalf of all the students of first year engineering, I will extend our sincere gratitude toward the Todkari sir. Thank you so much, sir, for your kind and full of information session. So, thank you so much, sir. So after this session, there will be the session of yoga. So there is one announcement. After yoga session, there will be the break for the lunch. And after lunch break, we'll start with the lecture of Mr. Kolekar sir. Okay. So.